Now we're going to look at placing ductwork in Revit. So we'll add some ductwork from our VAV box to the main duct, and then we'll extend ductwork all the way to the air terminal from the VAV box. So the first thing we might want to do is cut a section to get a look at the vertical conditions of this area that we're going to be working on. So in this section, we'll look at the first floor condition, and then we'll see that this VAV box is quite high up into the joist work. If we select this main duct, we'll see on the options bar that it's at 10 foot 8. And it probably would be easier, since we have plenty of room, to move this down rather than trying to work the duct work through the bar joist. So we'll select this piece of mechanical equipment and set it to 10 foot 8. Now if we go back to our level 1 HVAC ceiling plan, we can select this VAV box and we'll notice it has two icons that are basically connectors for ductwork. And we see that this is intending to have an 8-inch in connection, and then the other side has a 12-inch by 10-inch out connection. If you right-click on one of these connectors, you'll see that there's a draw duct option. There's also an option to connect into, which would allow us to simply select this main duct, and Revit would run ductwork to it automatically. But we'll do it the manual way, just to show how that's done. So draw duct, and you can see on the options bar that it's set to 8 inches. As the icon we hovered over said, and then it has the elevation matching the current connector elevation. And then we'll just go over to the side of the main duct and click on it, hit escape a couple times, and then now this is a connected system. To verify that the system's connected, we can hover over the VAV box and then just start tapping the tab key until we see the entire system highlight. If it was not connected properly, it would not end up selecting the main duct area. And if I select this VAV box and use the arrow keys on the keyboard, you can see how the duct and the connector to the main duct are moving with the VAV box. Now we'll draw a duct out the other side, so I'll right-click on this icon and select draw duct. And now we have on the ribbon the 12-inch diameter duct. We'll hit escape a couple times. And then with this selected, we need to add a cap to this so it has a totally closed system. We don't want it to leak, and Revit needs it to be closed to be able to calculate the total CFM. So with this selected on the ribbon, we'll select cap ends, and you can see it added this separate little end cap family. Next, we're going to run duct from this duct coming from the VAV box over towards this air terminal that we added. So we're going to select the duct command, and then in the type selector, we'll select round duct with taps. And then we'll set the diameter to 8 inches. And we'll pick a point just short of where the air terminal is, and then hit escape a few times to end the duct command. Then we'll select this duct run that we just added, right-click on its grip, and we're going to draw the rest of the duct from here to the air terminal, but we're not going to use the regular duct command. We're going to use the flex duct command. So this, as the name implies, is more flexible to make any kind of transition from the solid sheet metal duct to the air terminal. So I'll make sure I snap to the center of this air terminal and click, and then Revit automatically runs the flex duct between the two points that we picked. To have a look at what we just created, I'll select these elements. And then I'll use the selection box command. And then we can see the flex duct, the ductwork that we added, the end cap, the VAV box, and then some more ductwork back to the main. So this larger 12-inch diameter duct could also be rectangular duct. The other thing that is helpful about this being more flexible flex duct is if the ceiling moves and the face-based air terminal moves with it, this flex duct takes up the slack. Whereas if there were solid duct running all the way to the air terminal, which is possible, sometimes the adjustments to the ceiling, which then indirectly adjusts the air terminal and then indirectly adjusts the ductwork, can produce some unexpected results, because there might not be enough room in there for the elbows and things to adjust and become smaller. So that's a quick look at adding ductwork in Revit.